yon pov te sa A kote gran cheme ya Jel te a
Hello guys and welcome to week 3 of our Crazy Steps series. As you know, all of this week we're talking about the young girl who would later become the mother of Jesus. We're talking about Mary and some of the crazy steps that she had to take leading up to the birth of Jesus Christ and even the conception of Jesus Christ. So here we're going to talk about today the assignment that God placed on Mary's life. He also gave very vivid instructions on how all of this was going to go down. And I would like to say that he gave a double dose of reassurance that everything was going to be all right. You know, Mary knew and understood that this was going to be an immediate conception. And so, one, she's still in the midst of a long engagement with Joseph. And, you know, how is this going to go down and what's going to happen here? And not out of doubt or disbelief, but just out of sheer wonder, how is all of this going to happen? She poses the question to Gabriel. And, you know, the song goes, he's a wonder. He's a wonder to us. And I could imagine Mary dealing with all of these emotions of being selected, being the chosen one. You know, God had to have his eyes on Mary a very, 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 very long time. And he also let the Holy Spirit lead this whole situation here, because obviously Mary will be carrying his son. So this was definitely top priority, and you will see the Spirit being in full control as we look in our scripture today. The scripture reading will come from Luke chapter 1, verse 31 through 37. And the scripture reads, "And you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, and for that reason the Holy Child shall be called the Son of God. And behold, even your relative Elizabeth has also conceived a son in her old age. She was called barren and is now in her sixth month. For nothing will be impossible with God." For nothing will be impossible with God. And I want you guys to get that today if you get nothing else out of this message. For nothing will be impossible with God. God answered all of Mary's questions. He dotted every I and he crossed every T. This is a great example of being led by the Spirit, guys, because whatever God is doing, he's doing it in the Spirit. He's not doing it through all this other crazy stuff that we sometimes get ourselves wrapped up in. God is doing it in the Spirit. If you want to hear from God, he is doing it in the Spirit. And building that intimate personal relationship and being led by the Holy Spirit will get you to where you need to go, all in one piece. You know, maybe some stumbles along the way, but if you know that you're being led by the Spirit, everything is going to be all right. And so we hear God saying that nothing will be impossible. Nothing will be impossible. And we're going to talk about that last statement that triggered Mary's next statement, and we're going to look at that on tomorrow. That triggered that something went off in Mary's head and just gave her complete confidence that nothing will be impossible for God. You know, he explains everything to her, how the Holy Spirit is going to come and overshadow her. And he also talked about, not only that, go ask your cousin who is way up in age, who has been barren most of her, the entire lifespan of her, she has been barren and unable to have children. Go ask your cousin what's going on. She's going to be a witness and a testimony to what's getting ready to happen with Mary. And that's when we get into that statement of nothing will be impossible with God. Nothing will be impossible with God. And how many of us believe that today? I don't care how it may look, how the situation may look, what may be stacked up against you. You know, nothing will be impossible for God. And you have to walk away today believing that with everything that you have, and that will indeed get you to where you need to be at in life. Having that intimate personal relationship with the Holy Spirit is key, because whatever God is doing, He's doing it in the Spirit. So guys, thank you so much for joining me today. I'm excited about tomorrow. I'm excited about our scripture reading tomorrow and the very, very words that triggered Mary into moving forward and seeing this thing out for us. God bless you. God keep you. And please, whatever you do today, please remember that nothing will be impossible with God. Nothing will be impossible with God. Nothing will be impossible with God, because whatever He's doing, He's most certainly doing it in the Spirit. Y'all have a good day. Thank you.